Welcome back to our channel. The roots of education in America are intertwined with the horrors of enslavement. The oppressive system not only denied enslaved individuals their basic human rights, but also actively sought to keep them ignorant and illiterate. Anti-literacy laws were enacted in several southern states, including South Carolina, North Carolina, Georgia, Louisiana, Mississippi, Virginia, and Alabama between 1740 and 1834. These laws made it illegal for enslaved people to learn how to read or write. The first law was passed in South Carolina in 1739, following a significant slave uprising known as the Stono Rebellion. Those caught teaching enslaved individuals to read faced severe punishment. The act of learning to read was a dangerous and punishable offense. Those caught teaching enslaved people could face hefty fines, imprisonment, or vicious whippings. And for the enslaved themselves, the consequences were even worse. Savage beatings, mutilation of limbs, and the constant fear of being caught in their pursuit of literacy. But despite these horrific risks, many enslaved people, such as Frederick Douglass, were determined to become literate, defying the law and risking their lives for knowledge. Even after emancipation, the struggle to access education continued, with institutions like Cheney University, founded in 1837 by Quaker Richard Humphreys, serving as beacons of hope and progress for Black individuals seeking higher learning. In 1980, President Jimmy Carter created the Department of Education with a clear mission to promote academic success and equal opportunities for students nationwide. It has since been a target of criticism and opposition from the GOP, who have consistently fought to dismantle it. According to the far-right organization, the Heritage Foundation's Project 2025, their conservative agenda for policies under the next Republican president includes eliminating the Department of Education and privatizing student loans. These proposals could significantly impact how students finance their education and the overall state of federal education programs and policies. A radical proposal for reorganizing education funding and curriculum has been put forth, with potentially far-reaching implications. The plan aims to revamp programs such as Title I, which supports low-income schools, and ultimately shift funding responsibilities to individual states. This could have significant consequences for areas such as special education and funding for children with disabilities and low-income public school districts. There is concern over the impact on students from disadvantaged backgrounds who rely on programs like Pell Grants and student loans to pursue higher education. Project 2025 proposes a controversial idea requiring any public school receiving federal funding to administer military entrance exams to its students. Such a move would undoubtedly spark debate and raise questions about the purpose and values of our education system. On page 134, from the 922-page Project 2025 manifesto says, "Improve military recruiters' access to secondary schools and requires completion of the Armed Services Vocational Aptitude Battery. ASVAB, the military entrance examination by all students in schools that receive federal funding. Private schools are granted immunity from military exams, while Moms for Liberty, a radical organization hell-bent on censoring literature, gains power and sets their sights on controlling education. All mention of race, discrimination, or gender is banned, effectively erasing the histories and experiences of Black students in America. Any schools that defy these oppressive rules will be stripped of federal funding and left to wither away. Dismantling the Board of Education would plunge society into darkness, with illiteracy running rampant. Without access to education, jobs become unattainable and lives lose all purpose. Poverty and crime skyrocket as entire communities are left behind. In this bleak landscape, Black children and low-income children are forced to become unwilling soldiers in a never-ending battle against systemic oppression.